Voices in the Wind Audio Theater presents Charles Dickens, A Christmas Carol, the tale of a miserly man who comes to realize the true spirit of Christmas. When the story first appeared over 160 years ago, few observed Christmas other than a church. Few employers gave workers time off for the holiday, and the jolly country celebrations of the past were largely forgotten in the cities. But this little story helped transform Christmas from a staid religious holiday into a season of faith, feasting, and goodwill that has remained to this very day. Our story opens in the year 1843.
Once upon a time, of all the good days in the year, on Christmas Eve, old Scrooge sat busy in his counting house. Ebenezer Scrooge was a squeezing, wrenching, grasping, scraping, clutching, covetous old sinner. A hard-hearted miser, secret and self-contained, and solitary as an oyster. A morose and lonely man who consorted with nobody but himself. On this evening, the office of Scrooge and Marley was shrouded in cold, bleak, biting weather. External heat and cold had little influence on Scrooge. No warmth could warm, no wintry weather could chill him. No wind that blew was bitterer than he.
Rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day, to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray.
Merry Christmas, humbug! Be gone, you miserable little beggars! Take your infernal Christmas carols and get away from my door!
So sorry, sir. Merry, Merry Christmas, though, sir. And you have a...
Bah! And you, nephew. What right have you to be merry? You're poor enough. Christmas? Bah! Humbug!
Christmas a humbug, uncle. You don't mean that, I'm sure. What right have you to be dismal about Christmas? You're rich enough. Now, don't be cross, uncle.
What else can I be, Fred, when I live in such a world of fools as this? Merry Christmas. If I could work my will, every idiot who goes about with Merry Christmas on his lips would... would be boiled with his own pudding. And buried with a stake of holly through his heart. Keep Christmas in your own way, nephew, and let me keep it in mine.
Keep it? But you don't keep it, uncle.
Well, let me leave it alone, then. Much good may it do you. Much good it ever has done you.
But Christmas time is a good time, uncle. A kind, forgiving, charitable, pleasant time. When men and women open their shut-up hearts freely and think of others as if they really were fellow passengers to the grave, and not another race of creatures bound on other journeys. And therefore, uncle, though it has never put a scrap of gold or silver in my pocket, I believe that it has done me good, and will do me good. And I say God bless it.
God bless Christmas.
You there, Bob Cratchit! Let me hear another sound from you. And you'll keep your Christmas by losing your situation. Now, return to your accounting.
Yes, sir.
Don't be angry, uncle. Come, dine with us for Christmas dinner tomorrow. Kate would love to meet you.
Kate? Oh, yes, your wife.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.